crime family stealing the election. The media is covering up. The Biden crime family stealing this election. The media is covering up. The Biden crime family stealing this election. The media is covering up. We want our freedom for the world. Give us our freedom, Joe Biden. Joe Biden's covering up this election. He's stealing it.
We want all voting to stop. We don't want them to find any ballots at 4 o'clock in the morning and add them to the list.
Stop the count! Stop the count! Stop the count!
Stop the count! Stop the count!
Stop the count! Stop the count! Stop the count! Stop the count!
But we are going to continue the lawsuit here. We're going to bring a second one, and then we're going to bring a federal lawsuit. And we're going to take a very good look at whether we bring this nationally. We certainly are going to bring it here and in Wisconsin. Quite possibly, we'll do a national lawsuit and really expose the corruption of the Democrat Party. But this is beyond anything I've ever seen before.
My role is to work for the Republican Party to make sure the President of the United States does not have this election stolen from him.
I want Trump to win so badly because I think our country is going to go downhill fast with Trump.
Right. Here we go.
Yeah, I mean, we're leading it, dude.
Here we go.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here
we
go. Here
we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. And we fight regardless of who goes to the White House.
This is a critical time for the country where a fascist president is trying to stage a coup. And we're here to say that every vote must be counted. And you know, the election should go through the real process and not be hijacked by his schemes to steal it.
Unless the people stand up and make it clear that every vote has to count, the election will be stolen. And we can't allow this election to be stolen. It's too important. This country is living a nightmare. And unless we lift that nightmare, we're all going to suffer horribly. That's why I'm here today.
I don't know how to explain it. We must look like a mixed bag of nuts to the rest of the world. We're good people. Unfortunately, nearly half the country, those who were for Trump, they don't believe that there's climate change. They think the Earth is 6,000 years old. You go down the whole list of things. I don't know where you find a compromise. We are going to have to deal with the fact that tens of millions of our fellow citizens share beliefs similar to Trump's. A lot of this has to do with race, class, misogyny. You go down the list of things. I don't know. We're going to have some kind of conversation. We're going to have to figure out how to have a more kinder nation, a more educated nation. When you have so many millions of Americans as adults who are functional illiterates, which means they can read and write at a fifth grade level. So you don't have, you know, it's we've got to fix this because we are not only hurting ourselves, we're hurting the world.
Our politics have divided. I personally believe Donald Trump, if he loses or if he wins, will be the last Republican president, certainly in my lifetime, maybe ever. Our demographics are shifting, and the way the Democrats have partnered with the liberal media in America, everyone who doesn't think their way is either racist, misogynist, xenophobic, or just an awful person. A villainization of the right by the media in conjunction with the Democrats, this is probably Donald Trump, the 45th president, will be the last time a Republican occupies at 1600 Pennsylvania.